recording and get into it. Yeet. You go away. I need you up anymore.
Do you want to need this note? I don't think I need this note.
You will.
5 minutes into the session.
I need you and you. And this, I guess I'll just do... I'll just leave it there. If I need to write any notes down, I can go there, I guess. Oh, I forgot what I forgot. I can get... It's easier than just lounging.
There's no eraser.
I can go for it.
Where's all the body erasers? Did people go around...
Looks like people went around tearing them apart.
Do you want one?
What child did this?
Do you want one?
I'm dealing with children. No, I grabbed them.
Do you want one?
Oh, thank you.
Oh wait, I should actually make sure it's recording because I didn't check that. I just clicked the button and then hoped. Okay, there it is. So, it's not a good source. I don't know if this one will be part of the comments. So, Will. You've begun to be dragged off. They're not gentle, as they have grabbed you by each arm, dragging you so your feet are bumping and scraping up against the ground, and they drag you towards the Great Hall. As you approach, four men come up to the group wearing different colors than the current ones. You recognize them as those who worked under Ulver. One of them will step forward. Is he the one? One of them dragging you. Sure is. Give us a moment with him, then you can take him inside. All means, and they'll throw you down onto the ground, and the four men step over you and start kicking and punching, pulling at your hair as hard as they can. You feel some tear. Don't know how long it goes on for, but eventually one of the guys who was dragging you along says, that's enough. We need him alive. If he's going to be executed, he needs to be alive for his execution, not dead by your beating. One of them snorts and does a final kick. Another one spits on you, and then they step to the side.
Nice.
As you get picked back up and brought inside. When you're brought inside, actually, roll me an endurance real quick. See how...
Eight?
Yeah. Okay.
Will you take wounds or injuries from...
Don't worry about it.
Okay.
You're not... You're hit in the face a decent amount, so it's a little... It's hard trying to keep your eyes open. You can feel like one of them starts slowly swollen shut. But you can still are able to keep yourself awake and see that there's you get dragged in and you see a dead man on the ground a couple feet from you, and someone in front of you puts a hand out, a woman saying, "Who is this? What are you doing with him? Why are you bringing him here?" "This one here killed Jarl Ulver. He's being brought to the cells." "Well, the cells have been broken into. All the prisoners are gone." The and we'll just throw him in there and put more guards. No, you won't. They took the keys.
They only had the pair.
One of you get a rope. Just hang him up here. One of them will step off to the side a moment later, come back with a rope. They will wrap it around your hands, loop it through the center for a nice solid grip on your arms, so your hand on your hands, so the wrists, so they don't slip out.
Mm-hmm.
Throw the rope over one of the beam, over one of the support beams that go that are up near the roof. Grab on the other end and pull, and you get hoisted up about to where your feet are about a foot off the ground, and then they tie it off.
Comfy.
Super! Yeah, it's so comfy. Yeah. And one of them goes up to you and pushes against your shoulder, so you start swinging and spinning around.
Cool.
And they kind of laugh and stuff like that. Classic jerk moves.
Classic.
Classic! I don't know how I classic.
My head's probably just down and trying to stay awake.
Me.
Will they pat me down?
No, they didn't.
Okay.
Seth. So, you and Eric see that he gets carried off, and the men are dispersing, searching for the other the slaves that have escaped. And you are attempting to make your way around through the village. I believe you said, like, away from the Great Hall towards, like, the Dockstill area to loop around to get to the hut. Alright. How are you planning on doing this without being seen? If you remember, the village isn't like, you know, a bunch of buildings close together kind of city thing. They're spread out. They each have their own, like, some of them have like a full acre of land and stuff like that. It's not like super close.
The barrels.
I love it.
So dynamite just worked.
Yeah,
of course.
Stealth playlist. The name of the first song is apparently Seduction.
Yeah.
The barrels. We
use them as cover.
In what way? I mean, this is medieval times. So anything could go.
Separate. What? No. I don't know. I mean, we want to spend as much time, like, between buildings and other people as possible. But, like, are the closest people? Are they a ways off? Are they coming this way? Are they...
So
are there any fences or walls between the buildings?
Walls. There are fences, but none of them are like board fences or anything like that. The people themselves, they let's see. They have already primarily for directions, the docks are to the east. They have already primarily done a large sweep of the south and the east. The majority of the people there that started walking through there are further away. There is now a group of people spread out heading to the west and the north. That's where you are.
Well, it's raining, right?
Oh, that's true. Thank you for reminding me. It is pouring rain.
That's
Mm-hmm. What time of day is it at this point?
When did the fight happen?
Yeah, it's only like noon. Yeah. Wasn't it? Yeah, because you guys, Draven was discovered in the morning.
Mm-hmm. It's sight right now.
Yeah. That you can see?
Yeah.
Roll me awareness notice.
Well,
so you are like hiding behind a building on the opposite side of the tree and the little like the little clearing there, right, where the pig farmer's backyard was. You're like on the opposite side of that, so that
the last place I remember was... I think
that's where you went.
Yeah.
Yeah. What'd you get?
12.
Okay. There is one heading in your current direction, and another one that is probably gonna be 25 feet off on your left, walking, that's, if you stay still, that's where he'll end up as he's walking in that direction, and then another one about the same distance on the opposite side of that guy, kind of doing a widespread, just... They're just kind of walking by, looking around. Just seeing if they... Seems like they're... Just to see if they see anything. Doesn't seem like they're specifically looking for you or whatever they're like. Just kind of looking around as they walk through there. Those are the three closest people. Those are the only ones you can really see well because of the heavy rain.
Sort of like an opening where like I could wait for one of them to pass and then run over to a nearby building. Nearby, I don't know how close the nearest building is.
Close building is probably about, let's find out, about 30 feet.
So like if I waited for one to go past us, hiding.
Rolling 3d6 real quick. The guy to your left, the guy in the middle, the guy to your right. That is the speed that they are going. So the guy on your left will be arriving first. Like, you know, to your left first. The guy who is in front of you, walking towards you, will then arrive at you. And the guy on the right will arrive just, you know, to your right, about 25 feet, just shortly after the guy in the middle.
And what direction am I trying to go, relative?
To your right. You are currently facing the west. To your left, which would be the... No, sorry, you're facing the east, my bad. My map's upside down, and I looked at my map to remember, and I... it was upside down. Sorry, to your... you're currently facing to the east. And then to your, like, kind of... north-ish is where the... You just came from, where the Great Hall is. All your friends... Well, the people you just rescued, they ran west, which was towards the... outskirts of the village. To the east is the direction of your of the hut, and you're wanting to go, you said you wanted to go a little bit more south and make your way east to kind of loop up around.
So are they all walking in the same direction? Are they gonna cross? Or are they gonna do this?
This is you. Ah! This guy's walking towards you. This guy's walking that way. This guy's walking that way. He's gonna be arriving about here, but this guy a little bit behind, and this guy a little bit behind.
Okay. Separate. paths, roads? Or are they just kind of walking
randomly? This guy's walking on a road. One of the main roads goes across to your left right there and goes to right in front of the Great Hall. And then the road that goes up is past the buildings that way where the pig farm is, which is in front of you. He's walking past the big tree where all the action was happening towards you, which is that building. And then that guy's on the far end of the pig farm roos. I mean, that's what I'm calling, whatever, because there are a lot of pigs there. on the that side of the far end of his property, kind of making his way towards like a building that's kind of to your back right.
Okay, so they're all pretty much walking past
me. Yeah.
So.
And number three is the one that is walking directly past the building you're behind.
Could we get into the pig area? Are we in it right now?
With the dice there, number three is in the pig area, walking past that tree now. You're right behind a building, past the pig area. He's walking through the pig area towards you.
Right. Any, like, barrels, boxes, equipment to hide behind while I am?
Roll me an awareness notice. Get a plus two because Eric's helping you.
Eight.
There's no boxes or anything up like that. There is a long watered trough for horses and donkeys and stuff like that. It's full of water.
Fun. Well, if I were to go directly that way, would they have vision on me, probably? At some point.
There's a possibility. Yeah, they could have vision of you for... The guys on the far sides could have vision of you if they looked that way and saw it.
How covered is the tree? Like, is there lots of foliage in it, or is it pretty bare?
The one that three's fine? The big tree there? Yeah. I guess a few smaller trees and stuff around here, but that tree is like the and where you are, and like I was directly around you is the biggest tree.
I just want to find a good place to hide and let them pass as well.
Well, there is a building right in front of you. Yeah. There's the water trough. If you wanted to run back, try to hide behind other buildings or find another cover, you could try to do that. There's a possibility that the guys on your right and left could see you. It would obviously be your stealth roll against their awareness roll.
Is the door right nearby that I could try?
Yeah, there's a door there.
I'll gently try the door.
Roll me a d6. Let's see if it's locked. It's locked.
Okay. I guess I'll make my way that way.
Alright. Roll means. Aim. Stop.
and your stealth characters.
Wow.
18.
So, because it's raining, they get a -1 die to their, sorry, I have to roll through them. They get -1 die to their perception. You got 18?
I don't know.
Ah. That makes a lot more sense then. Eric dumped 10 of his points into it.
Minimum amount.
Cool. So, you both crouch down, make your way through there. You feel this, feel and hear the splooshing, whatever, squishing from walking in.
Wetness? Puddles?
Grass that is being turned, grassy ground that's being turned into mud. Actually, it's probably not really grassy yet this time of year. Probably gotten more hard, so it's probably not muddy just yet. Eh, whatever, who cares? And you start making your way that way. What's your goal? Are you just gonna go be going straight? Because these guys are just continuing to walk in that straight line.
That direction was east.
West.
That's west.
Getting past them would be going east. You're currently heading west, which is towards the outside of the village.
I mean, I want to look for an ideal location to, I guess, let them pass. So, like, a nice tree with dense foliage and bush.
Roll me.
Something like that.
A cunning with bonus dice in a blended.
Some cunning.
So sneak. So still cunning. Wow.
16.
I also get a +2 from her brother.
18.
Alright. You guys make your way that way with you hear like the shouts from the men behind you. Just kind of like calling out if the others have seen anything yet. One of them get like yells at some a profanity of theirs, and one of them asks what it was, and he talks about a stupid dang dog that just lashed out at him.
Dog. I immediately go back and save the dog.
I drop everything for the dog. But as you're going along, you find a... let's see how... you got a good roll. Okay. I'll give you the benefit of the doubt. Okay, never mind. What?
Hmm?
What?
What?
Just ignore what I'm saying as I roll dice.
Uh-huh.
So yeah, you find a climbable tree. Nice. It doesn't really have thick thick...
leaves?
Leaves. Branch leaves. What the frick? Can't speak. But I'm going ahead, if they don't look up, they won't see you. If they do look up, it might be a little bit difficult for them to see you with the rain going in their eyes and stuff.
Okay. I guess we'll climb it.
Roll athletics climb. It is wet.
Easy. Easy roll.
Wow, that's cool, great. That was, Nice. So with Eric's help, easy, because he also got a 14. You guys climb up, he kind of like helps boost you up, and then climbs up himself. Now, roll me a stealth blend in. Good old baked chips. fake nachos. I mean, fake Doritos. Are you okay, Connor? What'd you get?
Oh, I got a 10.
Okay.
But I don't like them. So they have a minus nothing for mine.
Okay. Approach.
Plus 5.
What? Approach.
See you again.
The guys on the far sides, they don't see you at all. I mean, you can barely see them at this point. They don't even look up at the tree. But then the one that's on your tail, he approaches. Like, looks a little bit on the ground. Looks like he's trying to find something on the ground. Walks up to the tree and leans up against it for a moment. Just, hey. Kind of looks around for a moment, pulls down his pants, start pissing on the tree.
As with you and pissing on us during stealth things.
He's not pissing on him!
He's got a really powerful swing.
Yeah.
It hits the tree trunk and splashes all the way up.
So you just have a lot of piss scenes during stealth.
Yeah. Sure. And after about 30 seconds of pissing, a very, very long feeling, 30 seconds.
He looks at us.
And then he doesn't say anything because he's embarrassed. You just watch him piss. No.
Don't tell anyone.
He then continues walking forward as if you were, never there. Oh, shoot. Yeah. You're right.
Eat. Wait. Oh, but. Time to pass.
A little bit.
Just like a little hour.
Yeah.
Can we do like a little hour?
So like a half standard circle of time?
Correct.
So about 5 minutes? Of an hour?
I was going to say 2 or 3 minutes.
So we'll just round it to 4 minutes.
Okay.
Because that's how rounding works.
If we're going to 4, I guess 5.
Oh, okay, so it's going to be...
You're like,
oh. Are you sure, Connor?
I mean, 5 is pretty close to just like 30 minutes.
And 30 minutes is close to an hour.
4 is good.
4 hours?
Yeah.
Okay.
I just lived there.
The rain just continues forever, like right in that one spot, so they never see you. So, you guys wait there for about 4 or 5 minutes.
4 or 5 minutes?
Ever. Fine. Exactly 5 minutes on the dot. Not a second more, not a second less.
Yeah, we're good at time.
That's true. I would have you, roll a cunning logic.
But I don't need you to do
it. Said I don't
change.
Okay. Good job.
You're there for 4 minutes.
No, it wasn't 5.
You were there for 6 minutes, you fool! But you guys...
Before we get down, I'll just look back this way. Make sure there's not another wave or something.
Yeah, go and roll me another cunning. I mean, another witness notice.
Text me. Come here.
Yes. Yes.
All ones?
Yes. Really? Wow,
That's right.
Maniac. Wow.
It's,
guess there's no coming.
It's, you know, you're getting, you like, when you're climbing up the tree, when you're looking up, like, you could swear, like, some, like, mud, like, some like, when it was raining water, you know, got dirt and stuff on the tree, like, that was on the tree, and, like, it got in your eye, because you feel like there's, like, a grain of something in your face when a raindrop hit your eye. Wow, this is a really intense.
These clouds pissing off me. Getting stuff in my eye.
And yeah, so it's really hard to see or tell. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. So you have no clue. You're going anyway? All right, where are you headed? North, south, east, or west?
Southeast, right?
That's up to you.
Not remembering directions or what they mean.
To the
According
east.
According to the original plan, we're going southeast.
Okay. Right? Sure. Yes.
Our whole remember.
Okay. That's fine.
You said a lot of directions and stuff, and then
And you didn't like encapture all the directions in your mind as I spewed them out? Wow.
Tried to.
Oh, you have an absolutely terrible sense of direction with the...
Listen, compass directions, I'm terrible with.
That's fine.
Stop judging me.
Josh is judging us. He cringes every time we get on a little tangent. Anyway. So.
He's just wondering why he's here.
Yeah.
Yeah. Like, I'm just here for you to beat me up.
Oh, I mean, I could do that in real life if you want me to. Do you want to reenact it? Connor and I can do it for you.
I'm in enough pain.
No, you're not. But yeah, so, roll me a stealth sneak. Or blend in if you're trying to blend in some way, but I assume you're trying to sneak.
Blending into the rain.
I am rain.
Oh, 18.
Good, because Eric didn't roll that great. And, yeah. So. You guys drop down, your feet splashing in puddles that are beginning to be formed from the pouring rain, and you make your way to the southeast, east-ish. You hear voices and stuff in the distance. You hear some shouts.
Ahead of us?
Just kind of around. It's hard to tell exact direction because it kind of gets screwed and muffled and whatnot when it's pouring rain. And you, as you walk along, it's a building. No one seems to be around there or anything. You're trying to stay off of the roads, correct? Or
yeah, mostly.
Okay.
Smaller road.
Roll me 86.
3.
Okay. Right? Well, no, it's not. 3.5 would be right in the middle. No. 2. Wait.
Yes.
3.5 would be in the middle.
That's 7.
That's not true. I'm broken tonight, guys. I can't focus. I just want to go play Halo. My Halo's fun. Don't judge. Anyway. Shut up. No, it doesn't. You enjoy the multiplayer. Anyway.
To an extent.
You're just in pain right now, so you hate everyone and everything.
Better options.
So do I. Buy the campaign. There you go. Oh, no. If you have Xbox Game Pass, just
play. I can just steal it off James' console.
That's true. Anyway, so one of the buildings you come across, you see light coming from within and noise inside. And as you are right by the back door, you hear the door beginning to creak as you hear the latch being lifted.
What's wrong? Is there anything to duck behind? She's right.
Anything? Nice. There's a cart that is out by the back there. There's also you could jump behind to make a stealth roll, or you could try to get around the other side of the building, which would be a quickness roll. Agility quickness. Your choice.
Same roll, but I'll go for the cart.
You're gonna go for the cart? Alright. I mean, it also affects Eric, because Eric is... Never mind, it's the same roll for Eric as well.
And he's getting a lot of sixes.
That's good, he needs them.
16.
16? Nice. So you and Eric jump behind there, and just as you do, the door opens up, and you hear a little boy's voice. Whoa, it's really coming down. Is it safe to go outside? Can I go play? You hear a older man's voice. No, it is not safe. There are things happening out there that are dangerous. Stay inside, boy. Cox shotgun. I mean Cox crossbow. You hear Eric go, shh. No. But please don't keep the really big puddles. You'll get sick and or hurt from whatever's happening out there. Stay inside. Fine. Steps back inside, hear the door shut, and then lock.
You had the shot.
What? Yeah, come on. Dude, scar another boy. Kill that boy's father.
Yes. Hang out just a second or two, and then... ground and keep going.
Roll me a d6. Another one. There's some things that I'm not sure if they're gonna happen, and let's just see if they happen. Sure, it can happen.
Why do I not like
that? One of the houses you come across as you're working your way around, it is dark. There's no candles or anything lit in there, so it's fairly dark, but and the back door is open.
Dark house with an open door?
With an open door, yeah.
Wait, kind of somewhere kind of hidden nearby.
Mm-hmm.
I'll listen for a bit. Is there noise? Anyone in there?
Roll me a awareness notice. You always get, you seem to mostly get 1-6. 11. You don't hear any noises or anything, but you do see what looks like a hand that is kind of coming out from the darkness, stretched out on the ground, and it is palm up. Fingers seem to relax, so they're curled, and the fingers are very thin and bony-ish. And you see some, as rain has blown into the entryway, that you see puddle of water that has formed that is red.
Red water.
Yeah, it's red water.
We should just
part of me curious, but we have bigger things to do.
Yeah, yes. Yeah, we should.
If you
You're leading the... Peek. Okay.
I'll just walk up and quiet like in front of Peek, I guess.
Okay.
Peek in there.
I'll just use the rule again last.
Peeking
as,
in.
As I'm going up, are there any, like, distinct footprints or, like, sign of a scuffle or anything? I don't know. Mud?
It's a little hard to... leading up to that back door, not, like,
up to,
no.
Like, on the threshold or anything?
No, you don't see... yeah, you don't see anything. As you approach and get closer to see this individual, crossbow ready. Your eyes adjust a bit as you get closer to it. You can see a bit better what looks like a bedroom. Very nice bedroom. And there is a decrepit old woman laying there, belly on the ground, eyes wide open, hand out on the ground, other one crumpled underneath her, and she has about 4 stab wounds in her back.
Okay.
Now that you are, like, right at the threshold looking in, now you will see that there is, there are footsteps in a part of the pool of the blood that hasn't been rained on, and it's congealed and stuff, so the footsteps are a little bit more dominant, are more noticeable, like, on the ground and stuff. You can tell, that someone was there, leaving Romy a cunning decipher. No, not decipher.
Logic.
Where are you? Logic, yeah. Yeah, I'm really... Whoa! Okay, then.
22.
Nice. Alright, so... You can tell that those are small footprint, like small boot prints, probably about
13 year old, 15.
Probably size like.
Yeah, give us.
Probably like 8 to 9? Probably 8. I don't know. I don't know size. I have big feet. It's hard to tell. I don't know.
I pressed 9. I had for 10.
Oh, okay.
I do have small feet for my
height. I'll just go with 8. Sure. Whatever. Ish. They're not
yeah, like they would belong to a 13-year-old.
Yeah, on the smaller end.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. There is blood along the there's another door that leads further in, and there's blood smear across that. And you can see kind of like a dripping blood trail from a table that's inside there.
Like someone was bleeding as they were walking in or something?
As if someone was making their way from the table. Like they're the blood drips and smears and stuff go from a chair at the table into this bedroom towards the back door.
Okay, so it's like her trail of blood.
Yeah.
Fun.
There's a lot of stuff in here. Very nice things. There's paintings and tapestry and stuff of art from Havergate. There is also being able to glance into the other room. You see some other stuff like some familiar, cunning memory.
Weird.
13. You see someone like, oh, that I've
You've seen that shield before. It's very nice and looks of Saxon make. And also within the bedroom there is a leather map, a fire damaged leather map hung up on the wall inside the bedroom of Havergate.
Go back to Eric.
Okay.
Waste more time here. Dead old lady just had a bunch.
Okay, well,
I guess we'll just keep going.
I guess we keep going. And you do just that?
Yeah.
But eventually,
look out.
You get to the point where you have to cross one of the main roads to get to the eastern side. You're currently on the western side of the main road that heads south. You have to get to the eastern.
We dig.
You dig. Okay. Okay. Nice. Genius. Why didn't I think of that?
We just take our bolts and...
Yes. There is foot traffic.
Yep.
So, how would you like to try to figure out how to get across there? As there are people around. It's hard to say exactly where. They're just kind of, like, some of them just look like commoner people who are, outside, some looking around. Others, you see two men who are picking up a dead warrior who picking up a dead warrior and carrying them off. There is a woman standing next to them walking with them crying. There's a few warriors around that are collecting like fallen weapons and carrying them over to some pile of dead people. This isn't just directly in front of you. I mean, like, at least 100 feet that way, at least 100 feet that way, kind of spread out. And it's not, like, dead bodies stacked next to each other. It's, like, you know, every X amount of, like, 20 feet, whatever, 30, 40, there's one dead person there. There's some people who are, like, taking down what looks like a, this is near the marketplace. There's, like, right on the edge of it. So there's one person who has, like, set up what looks like some sort of stall that has set up one up and is taking it down now that it won't be used this day and now that it's pouring down rain, trying to get it out of the rain.
Alright, so is the slave hut directly across? Is it a little ways
past? It is north, because you went to the southeast, mm-hmm. So you're going to have to
cross this
and then go north, yeah.
How easily could people tell that we're like Saxons if we were just strolling on the street?
What are you wearing?
I mean,
pretty sure you guys have like winter cloaks.
Yeah.
I mean, those have hoods. But, it depends on your role. It would be I would give you the choice, if you were to do that, to either do a deception act, a deception disguise, or a, stealth blend in. Because you're either, you know, sneaking along, trying to blend in with them, or you're trying to just straight up act like one of them. You could have it like on your back, but it would poke up some. It would look like you had it. It would be obvious you had a weapon under there, but you're not gonna be able to tell what.
Yeah, because crossbows are obviously not.
No, definitely not. Not at all.
Yeah, I mean, I guess I'll try and hide that a little bit.
man. Try and blend in.
Alright. And either way, it's the same roll for Eric again. Eric has three in quite a few things, I noticed.
My deception is terrible.
He's more of a persuasive guy. Eric just perfectly got the DC.
What, which is?
He met it. What's that? I'm not gonna tell you.
Oh, I got like way above it, obviously.
Oh, so, obviously.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
What'd you get?
What'd you get? 9?
I wasn't listening, lead.
I got a 14.
Okay.
Screw destiny points.
Yeah, who needs destiny points anyway? Josh doesn't. Actually, if anyone needs them, it's Josh.
I have one. Quality.
You both begin walking across. Eric's trying to, like, walk like he has more heft to himself. Like he just tries to, like, widen his shoulders to flex them a bit, you know, make it so that the garments he has on look a bit bigger, like stick his chest out, like he has bigger abs, things like that.
Stick his chest out to have bigger abs.
Hey, that's you down there.
I've got big abs.
Oh, what were these called? Pecs, right?
Pecs, yeah.
Yes.
Pecs. Chest
is
fine.
Or chest, whatever.
I got big pecs.
I got big pecs and I cannot lie.
Pectoral muscles.
And you guys walk across, and no one seems to pay notice to you as you cross to the other side.
DC was 9, wasn't it?
It was probably.
Do you want to know? Do you want to know if your burn was worth it?
Sure.
It was a 12.
Hey,
I rolled for their awareness and they got a 12.
He's just saying that. Oh, it was 9. He just wants to be good.
Yeah,
thanks.
No, I still have the roll right here.
Yeah.
You just flip. Yeah, I still have the roll.
Whoa, I have the... Wait.
All right.
6 plus 3 plus 3.
Yeah, we'll go across and duck in next to another house.
All right. Roll me one more. Maybe one more. Depends on what happens. Stealth sneak.
After we get the kid out, we're going back in on a murder spree.
Alright.
I guess I'm making up for all those 6s I kept rolling. Done.
Wow. Both you and Eric.
So I'm gonna burn blessed by soup.
Make your way through there quietly as you can. As you walk past one of the buildings, there's a pony there that begins to make a lot of noise.
Must have been the wind.
Must have been the wind or the rain. And the owner steps out of his house, looks at all of you, and says, "Hey, get away from there! Go! Get out of my property! Go!" And just walk faster. Both you tied. Oh, there's a lot of tying going on. This is really close. Just barely got the DC.
I wasn't even scared.
No. After more minutes pass, don't have an exact time because you don't know. Actually, fine. You're cunning boy. You're freaking cunning boy. You probably do know. It's been like An additional, like, 10 minutes.
I know how time goes by because I can calculate the rate of the rainfall.
Got it. Nice. Mm-hmm.
Yep.
And you approach the, essentially, the slave hut from behind. As you do, you'll notice that the back window is open.
Next to it and kind of peek through that way. Can I see anyone?
You're just kind of peeking through from thing.
Yeah, just get the one side and then maybe duck under it and go look at the other side.
Alright. You look at it from one end, you don't see anyone. You duck down and look from the other end, and you see in a... Actually... Yeah, you see in a corner, like a dark corner, one of the darkest corners, a boy there. You kind of mainly notice because it's just a little bit glint of knife that he's holding. Well, young man, but yeah, not boy exactly, but he starts at the sound of that and looks over at you and stands up holding the knife down.
It's Cedric.
Lets out a deep breath and like tiptoes over to there. I'm sorry. I don't know if it was the right amount of time, but I heard a commotion and I just ran.
It's all right.
Where's everyone that you went to get? Did you not get them?
We got them. We sent them out of town. Came back for you. Go try and meet up with them. There's lots of people out and about. But I think we need to go while we have some cover for the rain.
Okay. You hear behind you, Cedric. It's okay. Shh.
Very nice voice.
It's Saxon. It was in Saxon. You look behind you and you see Barkley is there. Hey. He's like he was like crouched down like by the one of the railings of the fence trying to hide behind there what little he could, but he's a small guy. And he kind of like crouch runs or whatever, crab walk, that's what it's called, I think. Anyway, over to you guys back there, and it says, "Oh, thank goodness I found you. And you have a friend. Good.
Yeah.
I was hoping that those who weren't around were in here.
What's up?
Well,
is everyone else doing?
Yes. Awesome. So,
awesome.
The people that came here with the distraction on that craziness.
Yeah.
They have a boat and a rendezvous where we're gonna meet.
Okay.
It's to the south. There is a I think it was like half day or something. I don't remember. About a half day walk or something. There is a along the coast. There's a kind of an alcove, and there they set up a little small encampment, and that's where we're meeting. From what I understand, it's only the three of them as well. But the others, I told the others about it, and considering they're not around anymore, I assume they all went that way too. So let's go and meet up with them.
I don't know if you saw, but Will was taken.
was? Was anyone else? Where?
I didn't see anyone else. At the fight. That's after going southeast.
The fight at the tree?
Yeah. Killed Ulver and then
tracked down. He killed Ulver?
Yeah.
Wow. He... Are you... Will! Killed Ulver.
I'm not making that up, right?
No, no you're not.
Yeah. Okay.
And they took him where?
To the main farm.
Yeah, to the Great Hall Inn. Okay, I'll meet you guys there. There's always a lot of guys.
Yeah, so you said it's to the south?
Yeah.
Have to go meet up with some others to the west first.
Okay, I don't know. I mean, it might be better to meet up with the others first and then go get the... meet up in the south first and then go get the others, maybe? I don't know. I don't... Oh, you sent them to the west?
We broke out the slaves.
Okay.
We were both on the farm. So if they would even want to leave or if they need help.
There's a slight problem. When the three that arrived fled, they fled to the west to try to misdirect them, to misdirect their followers, and then head south. Yeah, Who all was there?
Wallace and, with me.
Okay, well, then, yeah, just head south.
What is that supposed to be?
What do you mean? Two of them... are Norse, and the last one sold us out. He's an old, stupid man who's the whole reason we're in all of this. Screw them. Just head south, meet up with the others, and we'll be able to get out of here.
Hey, Eric.
I think I don't... Part of me feels responsible for them. I'm not going to just... I don't want to leave them out there. If you do that, you're probably going to just get yourselves killed. If you go after brain fart. Well, then you'll probably just get yourself killed. Well, then I guess we both have our priorities.
So, good luck.
You too. Don't die.
Same to you.
And you guys, he separates from the lot of you. How are you wanting to get to the woods to the west? Retrack your steps, essentially, or... and then head west, or...
Hear me out.
Mm-hmm.
Just
teleport.
Cast level 6 teleport. There you go. Or 5. I think it's 5. There you go. Alright. Alright, roll the percentile. Let's see if you end up where you end up. Roll me 20 d6s, and 6s don't count.
Yeah. I mean, yeah, that route seemed decent. If we could go, like, not next to that donkey, maybe? You know, the donkey was moved.
Mm-hmm. Okay, yeah, like, you can just, avoid that a little bit, yeah.
And then, yeah, basically try and retrace.
All right, just roll me a stealth.
Yes, roll me a
stealth. Just roll. We'll see, there we go. Wow, nice. Okay.
17.
Nice, yeah. You guys got, with your cloaks up, like, some people see you, but they don't shout out or anything. As far as I know, you're just people trying to stay out of the rain. And you're able to slowly but surely start making your way that way.
Sweet.
Will. Actually, before I do interview, I need to make a roll. One, two, three. And has it plus three. One, two. Whoops, oh wait, I forgot one die. Okay. Four, that's a 10, 15, 21, 24. Barkley's game. Barkley's pretty good at that roll.
Yeah.
Alright. Stepping into the Great Hall from the rain. Kind of taking off a cloak, toss into the side to someone who catches it and hangs it up. You see Vithir. He looks up at you hanging there. What is... Let him down. He talks. That was a long fart, dog. Well, I'm just... shakes his head. I'm not doing that. He killed Ulver. He can stay up there. If you have a problem with it, talk to your brother. Not that he listens to you. There will... He's angry. Yeah, he's gonna walk up to where it is tied down. And the man will stand firm in front of him. Step aside. Vithin, time and time again, you have pushed aside the fame that would come to you by being related to Agnar. You never wanted to be Jarl, even though you know people respected you. You never wanted authority. It always went to your brother. So no, I will not step aside. He'll walk up to you. He'll grab a stool off to the side and put it underneath your feet. Everyone back up. You people do. The guy who's standing by the where the rope is tied down doesn't move. Why did you do this, Will? You had to know that this was a death sentence for you. You're not just for you. You're a Saxon that killed a Jarl. What?
I'll say in Saxon. He's gotten Saxon down.
Yeah, well. He's gotten Saxon down reasonably well.
Okay.
He's got a two in it.
Well, that's what I got for his shit, so he can do, he can listen. Unfortunately, him being alive would have been the worst scenario no matter what. I already saw what he was willing to do, what he had done.
I know, and I was ready to kill him too.
Oh god. That was the issue.
I can't get you out of this alive. But I promise you that I will do everything I can to make sure that this does not spark war between our people.
It already happened. Now we both attacked each other.
I fear that it is lost.
I am sorry. I did want to work with you, and I did want to make peace. But it would have been... It doesn't seem possible, even before this.
Sorry that I was not willing to do what it would take to be done. But I'm sorry that I have not been willing to do what needs to be done to get this peace. All I have ever done is just spoken up against my brother. It has taken far too much for me to decide to take action. I wanted to kill that man. Thank you for doing it. Even if I see it as the foolish choice, I am glad someone did it. I'll try to convince them to give you a beheading instead of something far worse.
Say anything to
them. Interesting.
If there isn't anything you could do, it's better off not being around me anymore.
Persuasion.
9.
If you wish to earn the respect of any, to be seen as more than just a Saxon dog that killed a Jarl, when pain is dealt to you, do not cry out. When death is ahead of you, do not tremble in fear, but stand fast. The most slightest amount of strength in that turmoil will win respect in the eyes of everyone around. And if you win their respect, perhaps it may win respect for your people. Every little bit counts.
I'll do my best, I guess.
He'll step back, put on his cloak, and head back outside. As the door closes, the man by the rope will step forward and kick the stool out from underneath you. And we'll go back by the rope.
Super
me another endurance. Okay.
That's six.
You got a killer awareness. Killer.
It's not as good as it used to be, but sure.
Oh, what is it now?
-5.
Oh, so it's 5 lower?
Yeah.
So now it's just a
16.
Yes. Takes you a moment, but eventually you'll notice a figure in like a hooded figure. Seems a bit small, smaller than everyone else here, in like the back, kind of away from people, a little bit more in the shadows. You can't see the face, but you see a hand go up by its chest doing like that. And
I'll just shake my head, but I'm not making any.
You see Barkley kind of lift his head up a little bit to try to meet your eyes, and you see tears in his face as he looks around at the people there. Reaches into his cloak and pulls out a clay bottle thing, and he kind of shakes it a little bit.
Just continuously shaking my head.
Like, the guy with the robe that was kind of watching, he's like, what are you doing that for?
Trying to shake?
Oh, you need to stay awake. Grabs you by the shoulders and spins you.
Whatever.
Is that enough movement for you?
I'm not responding to
him yet. Yeah. Only in persuasion. Sparkly's really wanting to do something here. After some time and you've stopped spinning, barely conscious from the feeling sick from the beating as well as the spinning, as you're about to like slip into unconsciousness, you hear the main door open again, the rain blowing in, and you hear Agnar's voice, "Cut him down!" And the rope is untied and you fall in that foot or so and crumble down to the ground. "Bring him to my feet." And he goes over, sits down on his throne, and you're dragged there, forced to, well, they just throw you on your stomach. "Will, slave to Vithir. You are here responsible for the murder of Jarl Ulver, an ally of mine."
I'll scoff when he says ally.
"Peace must be kept, and for that you must be held responsible. Many wish for you to be tortured, brutalized before being killed. But some believe a quick death would be best." Let's see which he...
She.
I said he. I said, let's see which he chooses. But they're made it, so there's a chance you'll get a quicker death.
So you will be brought out and beheaded for your crimes. You will stand up. There's a mix. A majority of the people are displeased. Some of them shouting out. One of them yelling, Blood Eagle. Others were yelling to tear him apart with horses and things like that. But Agnar, when he stands up, puts out a hand to silence them and marches out. They drag you out into the rain, into the courtyard. Force you down to your knees where there is a chopping block. Standing next to the block is Vithir with an axe in his hand. You're forced down there. He kneels down next to you, puts a hand on your shoulder. Agnar ruled that if you were to receive a quick death, it had to be by my hand, and if it was not, then they would tear you limb from limb.
I appreciate that, at least. If by some chance, and I'm saying this in Saxon.
Yeah, he's speaking in Saxon as well.
If by some chance you happen to see Barclay again, tell him that I was planning on taking him on as my son. I was going to give him my name, Wild Son.
If I see him again, I will tell him.
Thank you. I'll just look forward at the people as calmly as possible. Which I am not calm, so I would like to roll a deception.
There's actually a roll. Will.
I was hoping it wasn't Will.
Will Courage.
I'll burn my last lesson point.
Okay. You take deep breaths, trying to calm your nerves, trying to steady your hands, your body. As you kneel there, looking forward, you see the face of the crowd that has gathered. You see Barclay there, shaking his head, tears down his face, and as he mouths, "I'm sorry, I'm sorry."
I think if I try to react, it would break my deception right now.
Okay.
I think I try not. I'll look at him.
Vithir lifts up the axe, then you hear him say to Agnar, "How many deaths on both our side? On both sides? Brother, how many deaths? Vithir, let this be one of the last that's required." Barclay will turn his face as the last, at the last second. There is just a quick, sharp pain in the back of your neck. We're gonna take a short break until the song's over.
Man, that's the first time I've straight up executed someone before. Well, player. Rest in peace.
You get this one.
Huh?
Do I get to this?
Yeah, sure.
For being your first?
Yeah. You can, in fact, you get all your destiny points.
It rains
back.
Harder.
Yes.
You get to go to Valhalla because you have all your destiny points now.
Oh, yeah, that's how it works. Cedric. You, Eric, and. Oh, that's. I forgot to bring up. I need. I need a font thing up because. Cedric, Eric, and Elric. you three, sneakily make your way. You guys sneakily make your way through the village, and successfully leave, making your way towards the woods. Now, you guys didn't have. Let's see, did you have a designated location to meet? I forget.
Not really. Not super.
Yeah, so what's your plan?
Fine.
How? Just walk in a direct single direction or
just like yell?
Yeah.
You're gonna yell? Okay.
But like whisper it.
Oh yeah. And yell but whisper.
I mean, there's no real super great way to go. Yeah, I mean, I'm just gonna.
Mm-hmm.
Like burn a destiny point to make it easier. I don't know.
You can do that. All right. Let's see. Let's see how this is gonna work.
Like, I mean, just aside from literally going around yelling.
Yeah. You can burn a destiny point to add a significant detail to a scene, such as gaining a major clue, finding a way out of a nasty predicament, or some other significant and useful element that moves the story along in your favor.
Yeah, that one. I guess.
So you can.
Big clues going on.
Okay. Oh, you're burning one of your qualities? What are you burning?
Crossbow expertise. No, probably burning expertise to suck. But that's your job.
Part of your brain pops. I don't know how that works.
That'd be me losing my memory work. Or eyesight.
Trauma.
You got beat the crap out.
You're
dead?
That. I lost it before that. Whatever. I was untouched.
Wait, did you ever get any injuries or wounds this whole campaign?
Birds.
Oh, right, the birds. The baby birds.
That was the only time I got hurt.
You got hurt by baby birds. Yeah. Alright. So, what you come across is they were barefoot, so you come across footprints in the mud of bare feet. A group of people.
Bare feet.
Oh no, it's bears!
Bear, black bear?
Brown.
Kodiak?
There's two brown bears and one white bear. Sure.
Or is it like an albino brown bear?
Albino brown bear. No, it's an... Yeah.
I try and follow.
Okay. Alright,
I'm great at tracking.
Let's see. How good is Eric at tracking? Hey, he actually has a 3. What do you got? 2. Alright, he'll roll and you give him plus 1.
Alright. So, he's like...
Clutch plus 1.
Yeah! I mean, you can make it or break it. Remember, each degrees are in sets of 3. So, that's 1/3 of a degree. Wow. You guys begin following him. He's kind of leading the way with you right next to him. He starts to, like, accidentally lead off at one point, thinking that he, like, there was, like, a break where he was on some rock and he started leading you the wrong way. And you're like, nope, I see it over there. And you redirect it. Yeah, you're helping him, dude.
That's what I'm here for.
Yeah. And then you hear...
Since he's mostly leading, I'll kind of be looking around a little bit, too, because we heard there were people potentially this way.
Well, you don't have to roll, because I was about to say that you hear some shouting, and you hear someone calling out, "Come on out! Come on out! We know you're in there!
Is there
or lots, we're coming in!"
Is there a lot of cover in these kind of dense woods? Or...
Have we got
to the woods yet?
You're in the woods, yeah. They're not super condensed. You can move fairly freely through them. One of them will... say, "Harold, go get the others."
Oh, we'll go up sneakily.
Alright, roll a stealth-a-rooney. Woo! Eric! Freaking nice. Dude, Eric is like the best.
14?
You got it.
Alright. Okay.
You're allowed
power mode. Okay.
No problem.
I got you, fam.
Siri, call the police. Okay.
Did that work?
No.
Okay, good. You're hiding under your bed with a killer in your room. Hey, Siri. Call 911. Okay, calling 911. I had to make sure nothing
actually. Hey, Alexa.
Shut up. No, it's not Alexa.
I mean, it worked.
Oh, wait, is it? Oh, it is Alexa. Never mind. Anyway.
Remember that time I ordered you all those dildos?
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Wait, what?
Nothing. Anyway, so yeah, you start sneakily heading up. You see four people, that have... Actually, let me grab the battle board. So, you see... Here, I'm gonna use your dice for baddies. You don't need this, right?
Unless you're gonna have me roll knowledge.
I don't know about history. Well, it's up to you if that ends up happening, really. It's alright.
What a beautiful drawing you made.
Don't make fun of my drawing. Guess we can all see this film.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, like, you have nothing over me now.
Alright.
Yeah, what are you going to do? Kick him out of the game?
Shit. Yes, I will. So there's 3 men that are gathered around an entrance into, like, a... It's like a rock, kind of like big rocks and stuff there that kind of form a quote-unquote cave.
Uh-huh.
They're just kind of big boulders that are stacked on each other or something. And then there is a 4th man who you assume is Harold, who was just told by one of the other guys, and he starts heading off this way.
What did they yell?
He said, one of them said, "Harold, go get the others."
Okay.
You and the other 2 are coming from this side. You were following their trail, which led directly to there.
Let me put on some trees. Tree, and maybe a tree. That's how many. Bushes of love,
Yeah.
And bushes of love. You are about like here-ish. This will be your brother, and this will be Elric. Oh, wait, what am I doing? Josh is here. I could have just been using Josh. Oh, well.
Yeah, use him. Use him, abuse him.
Oh, boy.
Okay.
Do you consent?
Okay, safe word is...
There is no
safe word. There's no safe word.
He's very trusting. So this
guy, I mean, he has nothing to lose at this point.
Gonna motion Eric towards this guy.
Yeah. Roll me a stealth. A stealth sneakeroonie.
Oh wow.
Nineteen. Wow, that was a good roll.
Chick. One.
All right. You guys will start making your way that way. Does it seem to notice?
Okay. Yeah, we'll wait for him to get a little further, and then kind of out of... Yes. And then...
Fire in the hole? Like, lean that way a little bit. Alright. Roll with an extra test die. Because you're stealth.
Awareness.
He doesn't get awareness to his combat defense. But you also get a... Actually, bolts aren't really that heavily affected by the rain. Arrows are a majority. Bolts, not nearly as much.
Yeah, they're waterproof.
That looks a little smaller and stouter.
Yeah. Yeah, so I won't give you negatives for the distance for that, right? We're three. And go ahead and roll it.
Probably.
Oh, and also if you would like to aim, but
yeah. I'll try.
Bro, all good or really bad?
It's good.
I rolled pretty good.
21. 24 for Eric.
What a man.
So, how would you two like to do this?
He's walking.
I shoot him in that. He said you two.
He's walking kind of that way.
Yeah, he starts walking and then he starts trying to pick up into a jog. It's a little hard.
It has to be the netball.
Okay.
So, that's where mine's going. Right in the netball.
And then Eric splits in twain.
Exactly. Yeah. So mine's pretty good shot, and then Eric's like, "Oh, sure."
Oh yeah, yeah. So you both you have the great idea. Like at the same time, you're both thinking Neckel.
Yeah.
Great minds think alike, and so you both fire. Yours going off first, hitting him right into his left Neckel, and then Eric's arrow butting in right next to it. Double Neckel shot, and the guy just collapses down on the ground, slams the ground, rolls, and stops him at me.
Sweet. I'll kind of check back over here, see if they noticed anything.
No. The number one over here, he starts to move up to the entrance, and as he, like, peeks in, a rock kind of flies right by his face and he brings it back. He's like, calm down, steps back here and whispers something to the other two.
I will reload.
I have character reloads.
Lesser. Are we doing turns or kind of?
You're not in combat yet. You still have stealth advantage.
So, and then.
Number three, pulls out.
Three.
Number three then pulls out a shield and he steps forward. Number two has a bow out and he steps to the side there. And then number three has a an axe and a shield. Number two has a bow. And then number one has a spear and a shield. And he's stepping behind number three as number three starts to get closer to the
to touch, and then
to its entrance. Eric will kind of like, what are you going for? From the one with the spear or the axe?
I forget what you said.
Axe, spear,
yeah.
Bow.
Axe.
Okay, he kind of like goes right there.
I've got a good line, right?
Yeah, you're good. You basically like line up to shoot through right there, and then he's shooting like that. All right. He takes the time to aim.
It will be the same. Still the surprise.
Yep, same stuff. Wow. It's a crit. Count how many sixes you have. Only one? Okay. So this guy will not go down, but right off the bat, he will be receiving two wounds as you both fire, hitting him kind of in the side and the other one hitting him in the back. Let's go ahead and roll initiative as he cries out in pain.
He doesn't cry out in pain.
Actually, it's probably like as the air gets knocked out of him. Oh, wow. Now Eric rolls trash.
How can he
breathe
when he doesn't have a neck hole?
You didn't. Oh my gosh.
Freaking talk.
All that for a one.
Yeah.
All of that for a one. So that's 5, 6, and that's 12.
16.
Oh, wow. You go first for sure.
That's what I do.
Actually, I don't need to write it down. It's you, baddies, Eric. They'll go with Eric.
Okay. Well, since it's my turn again, I will reload and shoot at three.
All right. He has tried to turn around. You don't get the stealth bonus anymore, and he now has his awareness bonus and shield bonus.
Feels a lot harder.
Yeah.
Nineteen.
That is still 1, 2, 3 degrees though.
These is 18 damage, piercing 2.
And he collapses down to the ground unconscious. I'll leave him there, but he's unconscious.
Nice. Not damage.
Yeah.
It's my turn. Can't do anything else.
Cool. Eric, lesser action reload. Then he'll fire at... That's like perfectly in the way. He's gonna fire at number one then.
Dumb bush.
I meant the tree. He's kind of blocking it. He'll fire at number one. 3. So he doesn't have that, but he only has those, so he'll... he can't aim because he reloaded.
He rolled great again. Freaking ranged characters. He got 2 sixes and a 5.
They just don't miss.
Yeah. So 17. Yeah. However, that's only 2 degrees for him. So that's 4 8 damage on the guy. Reduced to 4. He will. The guy will just take some health damage.
If only had that heavy crossbow.
Yeah, if he had that heavy or medium crossbow, you know, any of the crossbows with wait, doesn't Ryuna crossbow have piercing?
Uh-huh.
I thought it, I didn't write it down, but now that I'm thinking about it, I feel like it should. Light crossbow, nope, does not have piercing. Piercing starts at medium crossbow. He was bragging about his light crossbow.
It's a lot nicer if you don't have the quality. Or heavy crossbow takes a long time to do anything with without the quality.
Yeah.
If you shoot it every other turn.
Yeah. Alright. Yeah, so he fires it, and it hits the guy in the back, but it doesn't sink in deep into the armor. I skipped their turn. My bad. He is out.
Just,
this guy will... 1, 2, 3... 5, 6. He can't do a straight line at you, so he can't charge. So he'll use his full movement to get up to you. And then, actually, he'll get right here, realize there's more there, and try to position himself like that. Number two will then
hold the crossbow flanking.
Yeah. He'll use one action to get there and then fire at your brother.
Hmm.
And then your brother shoots at number one, but yeah. So fires at your brother.
Hits us hopelessly.
I didn't roll anything higher than a 4. 4, 8, 12. Your brother's combat defense is 9, so that's 2 degrees, which for him is... Wrong side. Wow, that's good damage. 8 damage. Let's see. Eric, his armor in 1, so brings it down to 7. Sure, why not? Let's be a 2-health squad. Yeah, that's fine.
Why not?
Yeah, why not? But then he'll shoot at 1, deal a little bit of damage to 1, and that will bring you around to, does Elric want to do anything? He's not a fighter, dude. He's gonna, like, hide in the bush. that makes it your turn, Cedric. Wait, I didn't bring up battle music.
I'll reload and shoot at 1.
Do it. Fire.
Filth pain,
that's only 1 degree of success.
6 piercing 2.
So that's beautiful. He will take more health damage.
And that's what it's on. Oh.
As it fires and as you like hold, like as you like reloading it to fire it and you shoot it, like there's like a little chip that gets up and the cord hits the chip and it slows the bolt down a little bit so it doesn't go as deep as you want it. Yeah, yeah. That will make it their turn.
Just needs a little sandpaper.
Yeah.
Do these people ever go?
They did something on the turn.
Whoa.
Oh.
The coward.
He with the
spear. It's just some random people.
He's gonna attempt to trip you. Probably fail.
I don't know if that goes off.
He'll use a full
probably agility
action to do. So I'll get a plus two.
Oh, well, it's against your agility.
It is against your passive agility.
16.
No, he got exactly 16. Which doesn't. You will be tripped. As he takes a swing with the spear, it swipes your feet and fall down on the ground, then he stabs down with the spear. And getting an extra test die.
That's bad.
It's not great.
Your combat defense is 9, so that's a crit.
It's a crit.
20 damage.
Just health damage.
Yeah, just health damage.
Wound.
He swipes at your legs, you fall down onto the back, and then he turns the spear around and stabs down, and you feel it sink into your hardened clothing stuff, and feel it pierce into you.
My heart.
No. Yeah, you're just dead, yeah. But now, feel it sink into your chest, and it, you feel it scrape up against one of your ribs, stopping it.
Ouch.
But that's good. It's good. You need to go deeper. But it hurts. Then the archer will fire at your brother again. 4, 5, 6. He'll aim. Because he doesn't have to move. However, heavy rain does mess with his thing. 4. Against that is 1, 2 degrees, which is 8 damage. That's not good for Eric. 8 damage. Reduced to 7. That's 2, 4, 6. So he's at 1 health squad and full injury squad.
Nice.
That's fine. He can use the Destiny point and he's golden. Burn.
He does have 1 destiny point left.
I mean, he literally gets the most out of it if he uses it.
Yeah, like, it's perfect.
If he gets hit again.
Well, it's his turn. I like the sound of that, because he... Yeah. Suddenly, all those things that hit him, they actually never, like...
They fall off.
They didn't pierce through his...
They just echo out and...
Yeah, it like hit part of his clothing and stuff, and actually didn't hit him. He's gonna try to take the guy out that is now on top of you.
Focus fire.
Yeah. He's gonna aim as he fires at the guy. Actually, does he have anything special to help here? No, he doesn't, because.
I was getting feed called focus fire.
Everything here, see what that stuff. 1, 2.
Shield. Armor.
That's nice. So that's a 2 degrees, which is 8 damage. Yeah. So the guy has to take 2 injuries. And. Actually, 1 injury.
Slayer.
Then be a 10. Alright. He fires into the guy's side and he grunts.
All health damage.
No, the guy took 1 injury.
What a whore. At least he's not hitting me every time he gets hit.
That would suck.
I was waiting for Nathan to be like, oh yeah, he hits you.
Oh, I forgot. He has to hit you for the time you shot him, and then...
Hit three times retroactively.
By the way, you're dead now.
Two people will come out of the back here and picking up you're on the ground, you can't see. You hear commotion as some people come out back there. And now I'll make it your turn. You're currently prone. With a guy with a spear that has stabbed in your chest.
What's that do for, like, my rolls?
Nothing.
Just makes his roll better?
Yeah, just makes his rolls better.
And standing up, what would that be for me?
It is a lesser action. You can actually make an agility 12, DC 12. If you succeed, it is no action.
That's easy.
I'm down at that, but I'll try.
If you fail, then it'll take the lesser action. There's, I think. I don't remember the rulings. I think that's wrong. All right, you can get it for free. Yeah, agility characters are like, wah! And I'm
up. You do it for
that case. I reload and fire.
All right.
That was a test roll, just to make sure.
Make sure they're rolling.
Are they all ones?
No.
No one's. Josiah is the only one to ever crit fail on an attack. No, wait, no. I'm the only one to ever crit fail on an attack in this system.
I still want to see someone insta-die from 5 sixes.
It almost happened once before.
Yeah, so 11 hit really good, right?
Huh?
11?
No, that doesn't even hit. You get up and you fire, and it just thuds into the guy's shield.
What kind of sorcery is this?
A shield.
Arrows keep flying. The arrows. He's never seen a crossbow.
Oh, yeah. He doesn't, like... He doesn't have to understand what exactly it is.
It's magic, clearly.
He sees that is this thing that shoots small arrows out at him.
I use magic.
Big arrows.
That makes it their turn. Well, the archer isn't firing at you guys anymore. Roll me a d6.
Six.
Six? Okay.
Kills Wallace. The best possible.
You think Wallace would come out of hiding?
If he's desperate enough.
No.
Maybe there's a big angry bear in there.
You know he would just surrender to them.
Surrender to the bear in the cave?
Oh, yeah.
Is that what that is? Is that a cave?
It's basically a rock formation that has a little opening there to form a kind of cave thing. A
bunch of rocks fell down and there's a little...
Yeah, fell from the sky.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
You will hear a thwang, whatever, from a bow and a shout of pain. Where's my pencil?
I don't know. You put it somewhere.
There it is.
Right there.
Okay, I'll use this note card.
Yes, by soup!
Can I, like, call soup down from the heavens just at once with this blessing? Like, how's it work?
You're just blessed, that's it. No. He'll trip you, try to trip you again. And he'll use his full turn. He got a 1, 2, and a 3. So he fails.
So triple?
Sure. Then he'll just make an attack at you after that.
Okay.
Just 1 degree. So 4 damage.
Take it.
All right, you take it, and you'll love it.
I do love it. Thank you.
You're welcome. That makes it your brother's turn, who. He looks over there. He'd rather help you. Makes sense.
There you go, bro.
Yeah, and that was a bad roll.
Not so good there, bro.
Nope.
Just roll all sixes or don't roll at all?
She got exactly, which is 4 damage, which is how much armor rating they have, so no damage. He doesn't have piercing, because the guy's at 2 health squad. Yeah, that's his turn, because he aimed.
Okay.
That will make it the people's turns over there. Let's see what happens over here.
They kill that guy in like 2 seconds.
I'm just gonna get him over there. It's your turn. If you would like to roll an awareness notice as a free action to see what's going on over there, you can.
Seven.
You can't really see much. You can't see who's winning or anything, but you see Guthni and Katla over there fighting with the archer. One of them has an axe, and the other one is... she has the axe, and the other one... No, actually, she has the shield. She's trying to bash the guy with the shield, and then Guthni has the axe. Your turn.
Pew pew.
Pew pew, motherfucker.
Okay. Eighteen.
Uh-huh. That will be 2 degrees.
Okay.
It's gonna be a good name.
12 piercing 2.
12 piercing 2 and brought down to... Oh, wait, it's piercing 2, so... Brought down to 10. So 10 damage. That's just a wound on the guy.
You win.
That makes it their turn. The guy will... Reckless attack you.
Ah.
Why didn't you do that?
I can't.
Both people can't do
it. Yeah, ranged people can't do that.
You just smack him with the crossbow.
So he's
in can be a melee weapon.
Set them off like improvised weapon or
whatever. The crossbow does like 16.
Oh!
Yeah, it says the crossbow does damage, not the bolt.
12 damage.
Okay.
Yeah,
10. Oops.
One health squad. And then the fight over there. You'll hear another cry out of pain. And that makes it your ally's turn. Your brother will
come on, give this guy another wound.
That's what he wants to do. He doesn't like what's happening to you. He just wants to quickly take this guy down real well. The guy takes injuries. Just something.
Yeah.
Oh, wait. He reckless'd.
Oh. He's dead.
The guy takes a wound.
Now you won,
essentially. And then the fighting over there. That's what makes... That makes sense. Nice! So, you'll see that Guthni over there is struggling. And the archer is distracted with him and has been firing at him. And then, Akatla, freaking nails him in the face with the shield, breaking his nose and getting blood all over his face now. Yeah. That. Well, let's see. Wow, he rolled great. Elric will come out with a knife and 1, 2, and he'll use his full turn just running up, screaming with the knife out.
Actually, he can charge.
He can charge.
Yeah, he's gonna charge.
He stumbles past him and falls on the ground.
He hits the tree. He gets his knife stuck.
Oh, the guy did reckless. So he hits, stabs in. He does one damage. Because the guy's armor. Hey, the guy's at one health squad now. But hey, he did something because piercing one. on the dagger. Good old piercing.
I miss shattering.
Hey, piercing's like
shattering was the best quality.
Piercing pretty much always guarantees you'll deal something. Huh?
Shattering was way better.
Shattering was dope. That will make it your turn, Eric.
It's very expensive to fight me.
Gosh dang it, I've done that so many times and I hate myself for it. Cedric. No, don't make it more confusing. Cedric.
Okay. I'm just trying to get this guy out of it.
What did you just say?
Kill him.
Okay, trying to take this guy out of it. Okay, that's what you said.
Murder.
Oh, and they killed this guy on
16.
16? It hasn't been his turn yet. That's definitely another wound. And he's essentially out of it. How would you like to do it? Oh, he's gonna fall unconscious. How would you like to do it? Yeah, he's essentially dead. Good enough. Close enough.
Uh-huh. As he's distracted with the knife in his side, we'll just go right up to his freaking side of his head, like point blank.
And it just into his ear, and it sinks in very deep as his head just snaps to the side, and his body collapses down. And Elric, who had stabbed him and then the second later, his head snapped aside and he fell down. He just looks at the knife, looks down at the man, and just like, since we're still in turn order, he starts to begin having a panic attack as he thinks he killed the guy. that makes it back his turn. He will fire again. You will see. Yes, thank you. Guthni collapsed down to the ground, and then the archer will begin running away as he does. Katla takes a swing and misses as he doesn't get super far, but he starts running off. That makes it their turn. She crouches down in front of him and with the shield out. Eric will... Whoops. Does he notice? No! He rolled trash. Eric does not notice.
Okay.
You noticed because you were facing that general area. He's facing away.
Does that make it my turn?
That makes it your turn.
I will. So if I use my whole turn to move, I can... Is it just moving twice?
If you use your full turn to move, it is 3 times your movement. If you run in a straight line, it's 4 times.
It can't.
It'll be 3 times.
Okay. Can I do that and, like, say something to Eric a little bit?
Yeah, you can say something quick when running by.
So, just kind of...
You're okay.
I'll just go here, around the top side, kind of a little cover from him.
But as I'm going past Eric, I'll say,
put it up my
one's running, come on.
Yeah, that, yeah, you can say that. One's running, come on, as you run by.
Yeah.
Alright. Makes it the archer's turn. He'll turn around and shoot at you.
Bonus or anything from the tree?
Did you want to?
I said I went behind a tree.
You went
behind
a tree.
You went by a tree.
Yeah, you'll get.
He did. Are stop you wanting next to a tree?
Were you still wanting to be able to look out and see him, or were you wanting to be completely behind the tree? I assume I'm
completely behind for now.
Yeah.
It's not, can't get too far. In.
Okay, that's the case, then he uses full turn around.
Okay.
He's booking it out of there. That makes it your ally's turn. Eric will start running and kind of end up near you. They're doing stuff. Would you like to continue to give chase?
Yeah.
Okay. I need you to... You and Eric will be rolling an athletics run opposed to this guy's athletics run.
Just say you're doing a flip while you're doing it. Roll agility.
I'm swinging from the trees.
What?
Six.
Six? Oh.
Yeah, I don't know if I'm gonna be able to do this.
No, you, due to your hurts,
so I guess
you start slowing down a lot, and Eric is passing you.
I'll probably just notice that I'm not up to it and say, I can't keep going, and just stop.
When you stop, Eric will slide to a stop then. I'm not running off out there alone without you. I'm not gonna leave you.
Get him. We'll just have to try and book it out of here before we can get people.
Alright, he kind of goes back and helps shoulder you as you head back. The boy is still kind of over there. He's on his knees now, just kind of looking at the body. As you guys come back over here, Katla is over Guthni, who has an arrow in his chest and an arrow in his stomach. He's not moving.
Kneel down next to him.
I was just, like, trying to breathe, trying to not cry.
I'm not very good at
roll me a heal check. A healing.
Oh yes.
Two.
Zero.
Oh.
Negative one.
You can't go in the negatives. Zero. All right. Yeah, you have no idea. I mean, it looks... Those look bad.
So I can't, like, tell if his chest is rising or...
No. You can't tell. If you...
I'll... Give her a hug and...
As soon as you come in contact with her, she just starts crying. And buries her face.
I did it.
You did good.
We tried to hide, but they found us.
We. Get going. One of them got away.
Wallace steps out from the the hidey hole there, and it sees him as, oh dear.
Thanks for the help.
Do you have any idea how old I am? There is nothing I could do to help. I would just get in the way. I'm sorry for the boy.
So you let a woman go out and do it for you?
See, she is very capable. You could have done something. You never do anything. You just stand over and make other people do everything. Even on the farm. I am not one with for physical labor. You all know this.
I think I was one to kill people before I got here.
I have lost count of my years at this point. My body aches with every moment, and do you know how hard it is for me to run?
That's all I did. You can't even lift a finger. Help people who have been there helping you this whole time. Right, all you are is a burden.
If I head back, I will likely be killed.
That's not our problem. But you've shown our problems are not your problems. Your choices.
Who was the one to help teach you the culture here? Who was the one that gave you the advice you needed to survive?
Who was the one that brought them to our doorstep?
That was not my intent. Wanna leave me? Maybe go ahead. It's not like I can catch up to you. At this point, Eric has come back with Elric next to him.
The kid helped.
He's a young man. Shakes her head. I think the arrow in the chest hit his heart. She'll slowly nod her head and try to pick him up, struggling.
Help.
Eric will step over as well. Boss will not. He'll step to the side to allow you to walk into a cave. Put it down. Atla will pick up the axe he was using, lay the shield on his chest with his hands folded in under it, and lay the axe by his head.
is a prayer to Odin. Standing up and grabbing your arm as the only person there who would give her comfort.
Let's go.
As you guys start to leave, you'll notice that Wallace is attempting to follow you.
Let's stare at him.
Oh, stop. Start walking closer to you since nothing was said.
If you come, you are fighting with us if we get into trouble. If you don't,
even if I wanted to, I cannot lift a blade. I am an explorer. I can help you with your journey home. On the boat. Expecting more from me, like, to be able to do anything in fighting is expecting a child to fight against a seasoned warrior. I can't. I've never even used a weapon in my life.
Someone else decide.
You make the NPCs choose. Wow. Indecision, Connor. Indecisive, I mean. Alright, then I will just roll a d6 to determine. Because
Cedric half wants to kill him.
He's useless. Odds, he go. They decide he goes bye-bye. Evens, they decide he sticks it. But... stupid, they should do it. Eric will say, keep coming with us, but we're not slowing down for you. Well, that's fine. I know the destination. No, did you tell them, or are you leading them? You didn't tell them, so never mind. He does not say that, because he does not know the destination, because you did not tell him.
I didn't want to say anything.
That's your,
for no one to run off and...
And... You guys start... Continue making your way that way. As you guys are walking, Katla goes from leaning on you to helping you, because you're wounded. And you being hurt slows the group down a bit, but it still is leaving Wallace behind, and slowly he is falling behind. I'm guessing no one wants to stop for him or anything. And eventually... He will disappear from sight. And you guys slowly make your way south through the woods, avoiding threats, trying to stay out of sight of anyone and everyone and anyone you can as you make your way to the meetup point. That is
all. As we're going, top of the combo, say, I'm going to meet the rest of the Saxons, have a boat. I don't know if you want to come with us, with me. Yeah.
was that one night you told her stories about your home? And she did find them fascinating. Well, not fascinating. She found them very exciting. Everyone that I know is back there. And if I go back there, I'll possibly be with the Vithir's slave again, or I'll just die.
Come be free with me.
Let me check some more. Okay. Let's do it. Bree. That's where we're at tonight's session. Still, for the night. Favorite moment of the night. Favorite will moment. And a good last question. Hey Piper.
What do you think's gonna happen next?
What's a good last question I should ask people? So right now all I got right now is favorite moment and favorite will moment.
Do you think Will made it to Valhalla? It's a pretty good question to ask. It makes you think. You have to think about the technicalities.
I know the answer to that. Sure, we'll do that one.
You asked me.
Alright. We'll make Josh go last. Connor, okay. You're first.
Favorite moment.
I liked yelling at Wallace a little bit. I don't know. That was fun. Freaking idiot.
Or Wallace.
Screw him, dude.
I liked him.
Whatever.
I mean, practically, he's like 60-something years old, which is pretty old for that time period. He's up there in years, and not much he can do in that way, but also, he didn't try us ever.
He could distract people like this guy. I mean, at least he did something.
Yeah. Yeah, he didn't. At least
thanks.
Hey, he killed the big baddie.
That you guys wore down.
Yeah. Wow, you freaking steel killer. Kill stealer.
Yeah.
Favorite little moment.
I can leave this stuff out. I don't have to take care of it tonight.
Yeah,
I liked it when Will had to roll himself a couple times.
I use a death tip point to not even have to roll it.
These questions
doing remarkable.
Nice. That's not true.
It's a moment I remember, so I'm gonna go with it. But the, him distracting and killing Uver at the end there to get the Sunstone, and because Steven needed to die.
Yeah.
Also, you saying no to Barkley, trying to do whatever you want to do, just saved him.
Barkley definitely would have.
We'd never call him that.
Barkley definitely would have taken quite a few people with him, but yeah, he would have died.
See in Valhalla. I think. All the technicalities of how to get into Valhalla, but I don't.
Piper, would you like to say something? Sure. Speak up so that the, or come over here so that the people can hear you.
Jesus. I'm sitting wonky all night. Me too, but I got the body of a 50-year-old.
Hey, imagine having the body of a 60-year-old.
Pretty close to it. I'm developing arthritis in my hands. So, favorite moment from tonight. The only moment that got me very emotional was Will making eye contact with Barkley before he died. That got me. So I guess that's my favorite moment. Favorite Will moment. It's not really a moment, it's more just a fact. I mean, it's a bunch of little moments. It's the fact that after all that, he still remembered to call Audrey Hazel. After all that, he still called her that. That's a special nickname.
I mean, he has had pretty good cunning memories, so.
Still good, but.
Good job, Josh.
Proud of Josh. Go, sir. Way to remember that detail.
I had to think about it every time I called.
I figured.
Yeah. Yeah, pretty much.
Because only three people call her that. Do I think Will is in Valhalla? Does he have the Blessed by Soup special? Did you have that?
I never wrote it down. I don't know
we
if everyone...
We technically got it, I think, but it just doesn't really do anything.
Well, I'm going to believe that because we were all blessed by Soup, there's a very slim chance he made it to Valhalla because he managed to suck it up and not... freak out before he got killed, because apparently with the Blood Eagle thing, I think it's like if you manage to get out of screen before you die, you made it to Valhalla, right?
No, so with Blood Eagle, if I remember correctly, you have to not cry out during the process. No screaming, no crying out. Like, you could show pain, grunts, you know, all that sort of stuff, but it is... If you verbally express the pain of the ordeal, you have disgraced yourself. Yeah. But Blood Eagle isn't something that's just handed out. It's handed out to people who have been insulted, like by people who have been insulted to a crazy extent. Like, you murdered my family in cold blood. You...
They were rude to me.
They looked at me funny.
I told someone two houses down. That's fine.
Alright, Josh, your turn.
Favorite moment was... I think being able to tell Vithier about Barkley's name, since I didn't actually... been able to tell anyone that yet. We'll see if he ever meets or sees him again, but at least I got it out. Favorite Will moment. Should have been thinking about this. Yeah, fuck it. I'll just do the same session. The execution. That's really cool. I liked it.
What? The execution. I love being executed.
I don't know. Just the most emotional I got into that whole season. The stuff I wanted, like, to say out to Barkley, and I could have said stuff in Saxon, he would have known. I didn't have to sweat anyone else knowing besides this year, but like I said, I think reacting to him more than just looking at him would have broken the facade of him trying to look normal.
And the last question.
I hope not. Fuck Viking. He hates the Norse.
He wouldn't.
Yeah, I didn't think so. Like Vithir's pretty much the only one he actually likes, Norse-wise. The other slaves, like, he's kind of neutral on them.
Alright. And that's the end of tonight's half session. It'll be marked as, like, I don't know, what are we on, 15? Like, 15.5, I guess?
Yeah.
Rest in pepperonis, good old Will, or his real name, Will Wine, that never came up. I know. Right at the end there, he whined so much. No, he didn't. It was a joke.
At the end.
Goodbye.